Hello students, in today's lecture of emerging trends in mechanical engineering we will learn about charging methods and its modes. Charging of an electric vehicle can be performed by either wired charging or wireless charging. Wired charging is also called as a conductive charging and wireless charging is also called as inductive charging. Wired charging uses metal contact between electric vehicle supply equipment and the charging inlet of the vehicle. Even though wired charging is popular, problems with messy wires and safety concern in wet environment are major drawbacks of this system. These problems can be overcome by charging the battery of the vehicle without wires, and this technology is termed as wireless power transfer, WPT. Wireless charging has been attracting more attention because of their advantages compared to the wired counterpart, such as no exposed wires, ease of charging, and fearless transmission of power in adverse environmental conditions. So this is a sketch which is showing you wired charging and wireless charging. You will see wired charging, there is a recharging station which is connected to grid, and this recharging station is connected to battery charger, and it is connected lastly to the battery pack. The charging takes place by actual connection, but here in wireless charging you will see there is no actual contact. Here you will see the grid, then which is connected to rectifier, which is further connected to inverter, and it is connected to transfer coil. Transfer coil is not having any contact with this receiving coil of the vehicle, and this receiving coil is connected to rectifier and chopper and battery pack. So this is the sketch showing you wired and wireless charging. So basically conductive charging and inductive charging, these are the two types, and lastly battery switching, this is a third, it may be a third type. In conductive charging, it utilizes connector between the electric power source and vehicle battery. This type of charging is utilized in residential areas. So figure is there for conductive charging. Inductive charging, wireless charging coupled with the magnetic resonance to transfer power from a transmitting pad to a receiving pad. And battery charge switching means depleted electric vehicle battery pack is switched with a fully charged battery pack in the switching station. What is wireless charging? Let us see. Wireless charging uses an electromagnetic field to transfer energy between two objects through electromagnetic induction. Energy is sent through an inductive coupling to an electric device, which can then use that energy to charge batteries or run the device. Why not wires? As per studies, most electrical energy transfer is through wires. Most of the energy loss is during transmission of with the help of wires, over an average more than 30%. It is exceeding 40% in India. So how this wireless charging works? Specifically, the technology works by generating 20 kilohertz frequencies into electromagnetic field by a power inverter which are embedded. Wireless charging electric vehicles are built with an onboard pickup device that allows an electric vehicle to powered by underground power line while driving. So here you will see a power line, underground power line is there. Transmitter coils are there, and this vehicle you will see there is a receiving coil, battery, and the electromagnetic phenomena which is happening here and which will charge the battery. This allows the vehicle to carry 4 to 5 less battery capacity or weight, because it only requires a small battery for minimal operations of the power grid. Next is, what is AC versus DC charging? You will see this figure in this, at the center of the car you will see the battery, and left part is indicating you alternating current AC charging, and on the right hand side you will see direct current DC charging. So there is an onboard charger, and here you will see this onboard charger is replaced. So this figure or sketch showing you what is AC and DC charging. What is that? Let us see the contents. The national grid delivers AC alternating current, but electric car needs DC current to charge their battery pack. An AC charger supplies the electric vehicle's onboard charger, which then converts the AC power to DC, allowing the battery to charge. The size of the onboard charging device is constrained by the space. Due to this limited space, the amount of power they can deliver to the battery is relatively low, which means that charging is typically slower. A DC fast charger bypasses the onboard charging device, supplying power directly to the electric vehicle's battery. The DC charger is external to the car, so it isn't constrained in size or cost, meaning that charging is typically much faster. Let us see the charging modes. Depending on the charging time and power level of the battery, electric vehicle charging is classified into four types, namely mode 1, mode 2, mode 3 and mode 4 charging. Mode 1 charging is considered as slow charging and takes overnight. Mode 2 charging is typically described as a semi-fast or nominal charging. Both mode 1 and mode 2 charging use single phase supply. Mode 1 charging is generally installed at home, but mode 2 charging is installed mostly at public places and shopping malls. Mode 3 and mode 4 are considered as a fast charging, which typically use the 3-phase supply and can charge the battery in less than 30 minutes. Depending on various connections and plug type, they are classified as a case A, B, C and type 1, 2, 3 respectively. This has been explained here. Level 1 charging 120 volts. Level 1 charging uses the same 120 volt current found in standard household outlets and can be performed using the power cord and the equipment that most electric vehicle come with. Making this type of charging available on your business property is a simple as install dedicated 120 volt outlet in your company parking lot. What are the advantages? No installation cost if you already have an outlet near your electric car is parked. Low impact on electric utility peak demand charges. What are the disadvantages? Slow charging. Two level charging, which is having 240 volts. Level 2 charging uses 240 volt power to enable faster regeneration of electric vehicle battery system. Providing this type of charging requires installation of EVSE unit and electrical wiring capable of handling higher voltage power. So what are the advantages? Faster charging time, typically 10 to 20 miles of range per hour of charge, more energy efficient than level 1, about 33% gain in efficiency. Variety of electric vehicle charging manufacturers provides differentiated products for distinct markets and requirements, including networked systems that can schedule charging, track use and collect fees. What are the disadvantages of this type of charging? More expensive than level 1, potentially higher impact on peak kilowatt demand charges for the business. Third one is DC fast charging. DC fast charging provides compatible vehicles with an 80% charge in 30 to 60 minutes by converting high voltage AC power to DC power for direct storage in electric vehicle battery. What are the advantages? Charging time is reduced drastically. It's nearly as fast as refueling a gasoline fuel. Variety of charging equipment manufacturer provides differentiated products for distinct markets and requirements. Disadvantage: significantly more expensive than level 1 and level 2 equipment, and high voltage 3-phase power connections to utilize further increase installation cost, potentially increased peak demand charges for commercial locations. Different plug types are confusing to potential EV buyers and charging station operators. Depending on the vehicle and charging equipment, fast charging can be slowed during cold weather. So this is the different modes of charging. These are the references that I have taken into consideration. Thank you very much.